everybody that came out tonight, and we'd like to remind you that there are refreshments in the back, that after the program this evening, we're going to all have fellowship together, and if you didn't bring anything, don't worry about it, because there's plenty back there, and we'd like to encourage you to stay and have a time of fellowship with us. Amen? We come up on this idea for this program. I did back in a classroom with a bunch of kids, and they were all excited about it, so I said, well, let's just get started. And we did, and everybody just jumped in there and cooperated, and I'm so thankful. And we pray that you get the meaning of what we're trying to say here tonight. You know, God gave us the very best that He had when He sent us His Son, that through His blood we could be saved, because we were Gentiles. We were completely, we were lost. And when the Jewish people denied Christ and said, no, we're not going to accept Him, then it came to the Gentiles. Aren't you thankful? Amen? Amen. So we welcome you tonight, and we just ask the Lord's blessings upon each one of you, and we're going to begin our program.
Six months after visiting Elizabeth, mother of John the Baptist, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth. He was sent to a virgin, espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. Virgin name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. He shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary to the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore that holy thing which shall be born unto thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month with her, who is called barren. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her.
Thank you.
dynasty was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all were to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, to be taxed unto Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David. They went to be taxed, Joseph and Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. Watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them. And the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people, for unto you is born this day in the city of David, the Savior, which is Christ the Lord. This shall be a sign to you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, and saying,
thank you. Thank you.
of God was upon him.
You know.
birth of Jesus Christ might just be a manger scene in someone's yard, but it's a reality. God gave the very best that He had as a sacrifice for you and I. That through His blood, we could be saved from a devil's hell that was a place that was prepared for the devil and his angels. And I'm amazed, as Brother Bud and I, we've pastored for 33 years, and I'm amazed at how many people know absolutely nothing about Jesus. You can ask little children, and they'll say, "Who?" But you know, it can start right here, right now, for you and your family. If you're here, and you haven't accepted Jesus Christ into your life, this would be a perfect night for you, just right where you sit, just to lift up your hand and just say, you don't have to say it, just say, "Sister Bonnie, I accept Jesus Christ." I mean, by the lifting up of your hand, "I accept Jesus Christ in my life." And then after the service tonight, we can sit down and we can have a chat together. But the Lord loves you so much. The Heavenly Father is jealous over you. That just gave me a witness. He's jealous over you, not the kind of jealous that husbands and wives are jealous of each other, or somebody got the job that you wanted and you're jealous of. Not that kind of a jealousy, but a passionate jealousy. He gave the best that He had, and mankind belongs to Him. And it hurts His heart to see people go by the way of the grave, lost. And it doesn't have to happen to anyone here. It doesn't have to happen to you. Your neighbor can be lost, and you can accept Christ in your life and be a witness that the best thing that ever happened to me, I accepted Jesus Christ in my life. I've lived on both sides of the fence. Trust me when I tell you, this is the better way. Praise His holy name. Mr. Cyrenius. and have fellowship tonight. God bless you.